Today we have a Chrysler stereo in the shop. The model number is P as in Paul 04704373AD. This is a common stereo. We've seen this in the shop many times. This is one we no longer repair. But there are some people that are still restoring their cars, so we thought we'd go through several of the problems that are commonly seen with this radio. One is the display is out. Second is the audio seems distorted, and the AM or FM or both may be out as well. We're going to show you how to repair this radio so you can restore the car and bring it back. We've jumped ahead and we've removed the top cover on this already. We've also removed the side metal heat sink. Now the screws on this side can be different sizes. When you lay this out, make sure you make note of where the screws are. Also, this is going to come off with the white heat sink compound for dissipating the heat to the metal from the components here. So when you set that down, make sure you don't touch it and put it in a place where it won't go anywhere like it already has across the face here on the radio and my shirt, my fingers, and so on. But what we're trying to do is we want to remove this circuit board because all three of these problems are on this board. And to do that, after removing the side heat sinks, we're going to remove the pin that comes out of the back along with the screws along the back and the antenna. Now what this is going to do is there is a connector here at the front. Has two white pins on the outside that guide this connector into place that goes all the way down to the main board on the bottom. So we're going to lift this up out and we're going to put more pressure closer to the connector underneath and lift this all up out of the radio, and we get the board out along with the metal frame on the bottom. When reinstalling the top board, you let the two guide pins come up through the openings here and push this back down in. It mates this connector up and pushes back into place. Now there are four tabs that need to be unsoldered and bent. One in the tuner, one on the side here, one towards the back, and one over here on the right. Once those are released, we can remove the metal shield that was on the bottom of the board here, because this is the piece that we want to take care of. Now I'd mentioned three problems with this radio. AM and FM possibly being out, distorted audio, and the display being bad. And those problems are all on this circuit board. We have the two output ICs that are over here, front channels, rear channels, and we have a variety of capacitors around the front edge of these components. What we've done is we've gone through and drawn a legend as to the components. We've done this so many times we even color-coded it. I don't know if you can see this, but we'd suggest drawing out your own components, positive and negative, for which direction they go and their values. There are five different values here. The two transistors here on the side deal with the display not working properly, and there's one cap here that we replace as well. Now, once the caps have all been replaced, this will take care of the audio problem. For the display problem, we've replaced the capacitor already, but over on the other side of the board, we want to check to make sure the two transistors here on the side have good solder connections. This is usually poor solder on these connections, along with a small surface mount resistor that sits over here. This one small surface mount resistor can have poor solder on it. Now, that takes care of the display problem, the audio problem, now the AM and FM problem. The AM and FM problem is usually poor solder on a surface mount transistor here. Resolder this transistor along with the two surface mount components next to it. We also have a power supply area. These are things that you look for when you're looking at the other problems. Make sure the surface mount resistors are all good here by the transformer. Once you've taken care of this side of the board, we're going to note where this transistor is, because this seems to dissipate a lot of heat when it works. I'm going to turn the board over and look at the same position on the back of the board and repair these surface mount components. We've seen with the heat from the transistor on the opposite side cause a poor solder here as well. I mentioned earlier the power supply. We also have two main transistors here. You want to check their solder connections and any surface mount resistors around there as well. Reinstall this, put it back together. This will bring it back to work. Hope this helps some of you out. Like our video and please subscribe.